the right order.
Birthday.
Well, that's a different alphabet song.
Play in today's all-day learning program is the critical vehicle for learning. This paradigm shift is well-researched and frames the newly introduced full-day early learning kindergarten program 2010.
We believe in giving the power back to the children in our classroom. We really believe that they're not just mucking around, they're discovering. They're like little scientists, always figuring things out in the classroom and really consolidating their own learning on a regular basis. We really feel it's our role to extend their learning and to provide things within the classroom that are flexible so they can engage in different activities.
But they're also okay with us coming in and playing with them and engaging with them in their activities, and we're finding we can really expand on their learning.
Beware of children at play. Play nourishes every aspect of children's development. It forms the foundation of intellectual, social, physical, and emotional skills necessary for success in school and in life. As the Canadian Council on Learning says, play paves the way for learning. Why is play so powerful that the United Nations has recognized it as a specific right for all children? In 2008, Peter Smith and Anthony Pellegrini described the four keys which unlock the value of play. When the activity is developmentally appropriate to the experiences, interests, and learning needs of the child, play will be done for its own sake. The structure of the activity is based on the program expectations and is organized by the educators but also holds the interests of the students. The process as it is happening is more important than the product or the end result. Multiple experiences generate deeper thinking, inquiry drives more complex action, and communication puts words to play. Learning is ongoing as young children play to create new combinations, to develop new roles, and to try new actions. Children are engaged, often smiling and laughing, sometimes totally focused, and talking during and after their play. Play is important for fostering social competence and confidence, as well as for self-regulation or children's ability to manage their own behavior and emotions. Language is the tool used to share their thinking, and questions play a key role in communicating. The child may use different kinds of questions during play. Statements with a rising intonation, I want truck, where, what, and who questions, why questions, when and how questions, or they may have no question-forming skills.
We certainly ask questions on a regular basis, but we also see them trying to seek their own answers because they are knowing that they're comfortable in the classroom and they can make their own discoveries on a regular basis there. So they are, and they're asking each other a lot of questions too and trying to come up with their answers together.
We might have to change the question 2-3 times before they actually understand what we're trying to ask them, but it's being flexible enough to work with their level of thinking.
In conversations with students, peppered with statements and questions, educators model language and extend children's language use. Knowledge of the child's development guides the teacher, who is careful not to close down conversations by asking too many questions or those one-word answer questions. It is during play that children have rich conversations that develop listening and language skills, including the asking and answering of thought-provoking questions.
So they're having those real experiences, so it's not just the end product, but it's the means of the process throughout the entire day, and we're stepping in, trying not to be a helicopter or sabotaging their play too. That's a tricky balance sometimes, mm-hmm. but they're really encouraging that growth is happening and trying not to miss those moments. And having two of us in the room, we're able to do that a lot easier.
The selection of materials must be thoughtful and offer opportunities for the child to compare, predict, hypothesize, create generalizations, and to be challenged but not overwhelmed. The zone for learning is the growing edge in which children can absorb challenge and balance risk with the chance of success. Wanting to extend the play, educators need to be part of the play, to model it, to see it from the child's perspective, and to scaffold the language. Note that Jen invites Colin into the conversation wherever possible.
What are you building here?
A ramp.
Okay, yes.
How are you building it?
Columns are bigger than this.
What happened?
It went far.
You think it went further? You want to try again? What about if you use a car with smaller wheels, Colin? What do you think will happen?
Watch this.
Why'd that fall off?
Lifelong success will depend on children having a toolkit of skills, which include collaboration or teamwork, content like literacy and numeracy, communication including both oral and written, creative innovation, and confidence. Each of these 5 C's is nurtured in play. As children move from the block center to real life, the data is striking. Successful learning at play provides skills for a bright future.
A, B, C, D.